Back to the grind with the only free MMA channel that fucking matters, full-time MMA. And we got some motherfucking good news, some breaking news. Let's get it! Donald Cowboy Cerrone has been rescheduled. His bout with Robbie Lawler has been rescheduled and it's not far away. They were supposed to fight at UFC 213 on the Amandez versus Valentina Shevchenko card, but it was rescheduled. Donald Cerrone had to pull out of his first fight ever, according to this article. That shit could be fake news like a motherfucker. Sounds good. We all know Donald Cerrone has a man on deck, but I do not know if this was his first time ever having to pull out, but that is what this article says. So, we're going with it. Donald Cerrone, he had to pull out. It was a minor injury. It was actually, he just had a blood infection, and the bout has officially been rescheduled for UFC 214, and holy butterballs, that card is stacked. Fucking stacked. Most stacked card of the year. 100%. Listen to this. John Jones, Cormier 2 at the top. You got Tyron Woodley versus Damian Maya on it. Chris Cyborg versus Tanya Evinger. There's three title fights, plus Donald Cerrone versus Robbie Lawler, plus Jason Knight. I forgot about Jason Knight. Holy shit. Plus Jason Knight versus Ricardo Lamas. Oh, fuck. You got to buy this card. You can't even stream this card, man. I'm motherfucking... you got to figure this shit out. You got to get the boys together. Everybody throwing 15 bucks. Four people. You got the pay-per-view. That's what I'm going to have to do. There's literally zero way I'm taking a chance of this watch stream and that shit being laggy on this pay-per-view. You're insane. This might be the best pay-per-view in the last, I want to say, 2 years. To me, holy fuck. Even UFC 205. You had some really good fights on 205, but this one, literally 1 through 5, every single fight is insane. I'm going to go over the card once again just to blow my own mind real fast. John Jones, Daniel Cormier 2, title fight. Tyron Woodley, Damian Maya, title fight. Fuck, what's the other title fight? Oh, Chris Cyborg versus Tanya Evinger, title fight. Robbie Lawler versus Donald Cerrone. Jason Knight versus Ricardo Lamas. Holy flying. Fuck, dude, that's insane. If you're a hardcore fan right now, you probably got to go clean up a little mess you made in your pants just from hearing that fucking card, because I know I do, actually. So I need to get out of here pretty quick. I'm just fucking around. But that shit is crazy. Donald Cerrone versus Robbie Lawler was on UFC 213, Shevchenko versus Nunes. That was, you know, that was a card that pushed this card over the edge. Is one you gotta buy. You still gotta, this one is still worth the money. UFC 213 is still worth the money. But the moving Robbie Lawler, Donald Cerrone to UFC 214, that just made that card worth $100 damn near. I would literally rather pay $100 for UFC 214 than Conor Mayweather. Me personally, as an MMA fan, I cannot wait for UFC 214. Jason Knight. I'm a fucking huge fan of Jason Knight. Young prospect, star prospect, fighting his way into the top five. What the fuck you tab, Matt? Then we go up to Cowboy versus Robbie Lawler. Insane fucking welterweight fight. Gonna be fireworks. Fucking fight of the night, most likely. Actually, Jason Knight might take fight of the night. So, then we got fucking Chris Cyborg, Tanya Evinger. Tanya Evinger, hell of a story by Tanya Evinger, coming over from Invicta, bantamweight champion in Invicta, couldn't get her shot in the UFC, dominating chick, still wouldn't get the call. The girl she was beating would get the call. She still wouldn't get the call. UFC finally gives her the call, but they say you gotta fight Cyborg. So she's got the call. Now she's gotta come put a woman on deck against Cyborg. Tyron Woodley, Damian Maya. Probably not fight of the night, but Tyron Woodley's one of my favorite fighters. Yes, it's probably going to be not the most entertaining fight, but I'm just looking forward to see Tyron Woodley get past these boring-ass fighters as far as their styles. So, because he's a boring-ass fighter whenever he has to fucking fight like that. Tyron Woodley is like, who are we just talking about being a cerebral fighter? So they're not going to play into your game plan. Robert Whittaker, he's a smart fighter. He's not going to go fucking balls deep, guns blazing, fucking just to impress the fans. If you want to fucking be a counter striker, this might be a boring fight. If you want to hold on to me, I'm gonna have to prevent the takedown. I'm gonna have to be fucking I don't know. But I actually think Tyron Woodley not even just Tyron Woodley. Damian Maia could get a finish here. This fight could go to a finish, but so could the Wonder Boy fight. Tyron Woodley versus Wonder Boy. Either fight could have been a finish. If Tyron Woodley went in with reckless abandon and got caught by a counterstrike, or if Wonder Boy wasn't able to get out the choke, or if one of Tyron Woodley's shots would have finished the fight. Either one of those fights could have been a finish, but since it wasn't a finish, there was a lot of complaints. So this fight could go the same way. It could either be a boring fight, or it could be a finish. Either way, but it's probably not going to be fight of the night. Now, the fucking main event, John Jones, Daniel Cormier. Holy fucking shit. John Jones, only person to ever beat Daniel Cormier. John Jones, undefeated. Been suspended due to fucking steroids. Didn't look too good in his last fight. I mean, dick pills, not steroids. Same difference. He looked good in his last fight versus OSP. He was dominant. It was a unanimous decision, but it wasn't exciting. It wasn't entertaining, but he had reasons for that. He was trying to save his body for UFC 200. In my opinion, I thought he was going to do that before the fight started. I was like, if he was smart, he would try and not get fucked up so he can still fight on UFC 200, which is what he went in there and did. Fought a smart, boring, safe fight. Was supposed to fight at UFC 200. Got suspended for them dirty dick pills. Now he can't motherfucking do it anymore. Now he fucking couldn't fight on UFC 200, got pulled off the card, and now he's back. This will be interesting, though, because leave you with this. If John Jones loses to Daniel Cormier, they will be the first person to beat each other. John Jones will be the first person to ever beat Daniel Cormier. Daniel Cormier is undefeated at heavyweight, moved down to lightweight, undefeated at light heavyweight, except for to John Jones. John Jones, he's been light heavyweight his entire career, I believe, and he's undefeated except for one disqualification loss where he was thrown an illegal elbow, but he was dominating the fight, so he is undefeated. So if Cormier is able to beat him, he'll be the first person to beat each other. That means it will set up one of the biggest rubber matches in the history of ever. I'm rooting for Daniel Cormier to win, and not only that, you wouldn't know who to pick in the rematch, because you could say John Jones only won the first fight because of steroids, or you could say Daniel Cormier got lucky the second fight. Whichever side you're on, you're not going to fucking alter your point. Either way, man, right in the middle is where you want to be. I'm not rooting for Daniel Cormier. I'm just rooting for the rubber match. So I'm low-key picking Daniel Cormier to win, but I don't give a damn who wins. It's just going to be epic to see what the fuck happens in the cage. With that being said, I don't know what else to say, man. Fuck it. It is what it is. Let the hitters know what you think in the comments about Cerrone Lawler on 214. Because we went off on a tangent.